Yeah, so my name is Suzanne, and you can see my collaborators, the names down there. We are all from the Life Sciences Educational Research Group, so here in Liverpool, in the School of Life Sciences. And I'm going to talk to you about some unintended consequences of lecture capture. This is part of a bigger project, a research project where the main research question is, how does lecture capture affect student learning? We're focusing on the School of Life Sciences, and I should say that for the last, I think, 3 or 4 years, basically almost all lectures in the life sciences are being recorded, and the recordings are being made available pretty quickly, within a day latest, I would say. So in this project, we have been asking students from all years, from year one to postgraduates, and we've been using a mixed method approach. So we have done a student survey with nearly 700 responses, and we have done 2 focus groups with 11 students so far. Now, probably it won't surprise you to learn that students are very much in favor of lecture capture. So we asked the students, do you think that lecture capture improves your learning? And yes, definitely is the resounding answer. So the vast majority of students really think that lecture capture is improving their learning. But in our project, we wanted to explore this a little bit more, and you're going to see some of our results here. We did ask them, what are your most important reasons for watching lecture recordings? And some of this will tie in with the previous talk we've just seen. Students were asked to tick the 3 most important, or up to 3, the most important reasons. And it won't surprise you to see that exam revision was top of the list, closely followed by catching up missed lectures. But also missing, filling gaps in the notes, clarifying material, helping to remember stuff. I will come back to exam revision a little bit later, but I want to focus briefly on the notion of catching up on missed lectures. So lecture capture and attendance, it's a bit of a hot topic. As we learned, a lot of staff are thinking that students skip lectures because the lectures are being recorded. So we wanted to know whether students see it in the same way. So we asked them, in this survey, does the fact that you can expect every lecture to be recorded actually affect your attendance? And this is the result. So luckily, quite a few said no, not at all. But as you can see towards the right of this, there's quite a large group who say very much so. So about a third of the students clearly admit that their attendance is being affected by the fact that lecture recordings are being provided. Okay? Now, of course, you could argue, doesn't matter, they get the lecture recording, so they can catch up, and so it shouldn't really affect their performance at all. But do they really catch up? So we did ask them about, if you miss a lecture, how likely are you to watch the lecture recordings? And we asked this in 2 steps. We asked, how likely are you to watch the lecture recording at some point? And nearly 80% said very likely. So yes, at some point they will watch the missed lecture. But then we also wanted to know whether they're actually really catching up on time, whether they're keeping up with the lecture. And so we asked them also, how likely are you to watch within a week? And these are the orange bars here. And as you can see, the percentage goes down quite dramatically. So it's not that many students who really keep up. And when they miss the lecture, yes, they might watch it at some point, probably during the revision time, but not immediately. So that means they haven't caught up the lecture they missed. So if they go to the next lecture, they miss quite a bit of a chunk, and they might not have the progression that we envisage that they should have. So this is one area that might need a little bit more consideration there as well. But a lot of students said, no, it doesn't affect me. And so we were interested in also to see how students who attend lectures, how are they using these lecture recordings? What do they do with them? So first of all, we asked them how many recordings of lectures that you did attend do you actually also watch from start to finish? And this is the result. To the left, all or almost all. To the right, none or almost none. And what we take from that is that the majority, about 65% of the students, watch at least half of the lectures that they also attended from start to finish. That's a lot of watching of lecture recordings. That's a lot of time spent watching lecture recordings. And that worried us a little bit, and this is what we then wanted to explore a little bit more also in the focus group that Scott helped us with it as well. So I'm going to share with you some results, some things that we drew from these focus groups. And one of the outcomes of that was that, yes, indeed, all this watching of lecture recordings has an effect on how the students spend the time, what they do in their time that we think they should do independent learning. So all this watching lecture recordings doesn't seem to leave them any time to read around a subject. So typical comments were, I usually go through the recordings like two or three times while we're revising. Another said, I mean, I could read textbooks, but I'm still trying to catch up, so I don't really end up having time to look at textbooks. Or this one, after going over the recording like for 2 hours, you can't then on top of that spend 2 hours looking at things that could be related. I'm not saying it's all students, but quite a few students said something like this. I have to say more towards the first year than towards the final year, so there were some slight differences in which year of study they were in, but there was quite a theme coming through. So no time to read. But also, and this is related to that, watching lecture recordings is easier than reading up. So this student said it takes a long time to read around a subject when you could just put on a lecture capture and watch that instead. Much easier. Or if you read something, then a lot of the time it's really difficult. It takes far longer reading research papers than it does just listening to a lecture. Or obviously, it's just like the easiest thing to do is just go to the screen capture. So not just that I don't have the time to read in addition to that, but also it is easier. And that has some relationship also with the assessment, with the exam in particular, because that also is related to the revision. So they're not just using it during the week when the lectures go on and they want to catch up their notes and so on, but also during revision. Revision, for many students, or quite a few students, comes down to watching lecture videos. So here, everything you asked in the exam is in the lecture. So I think if you didn't have the lecture capture and you had to read around it, how would you know you were reading the right thing? And that is the thing, that is a theme that also comes through this worry, oh God, I might be reading something that in the end I don't need in the exam. Oh God. So they want to make sure they read the right thing. Or this one, I feel like going to watch screen capture and just understanding what the lecturer said word by word is going to be the revision. So there are some themes coming through that I personally find a bit worrying. It shows a kind of reliance on the lecture, on the screen capture, on what we say in the lecture, because that's gospel, and they don't need anything else, and that's what they're revising from. And inevitably, that leads to some stress if the lecture recordings fail, because sometimes, occasionally, the technology fails, or there are a few obstinate lecturers who just don't do it, so it's very few, but in some cases there is no lecture recording, so the students get really stressed about it, so it's like really stressful. I do get stressed out when it's not recording. This student said, if I don't understand here and now in the lecture, this is now, then I just never will. So if I don't understand it now, I will never will if there is no recording. So this is my only chance to understand this. Or this one, if you miss it, that could affect your grade. So it's just here and then gone. So you cannot catch up on this. That's your chance, gone. And it's not surprising that this leads to a panic feeling among some students if there is no lecture recording. So just wrap up, a conclusion summary regarding the attendance and catching up. 1/3 of the students admit to being less likely to attend lectures if these lectures are being recorded. And only half of the students who do miss lectures watch these recordings within a week. I think that's worrying. And in relation to the use and the reliance often on readings, most students watch at least half of the recordings from start to finish, so a lot of time is being used watching lecture recordings. So it's a lot of time. Lecture recordings, at least in some students, seem to replace any reading around the subject. Learning seems to be seen as memorizing lecture material. Remember the quote, word by word. That is my revision. I learn word by word what the lecturer said. I think that's partly our fault in how we set the assessments, of course, but it shows what the students think learning is. And of course, this feeling of being really stressed when recordings fail or are not being provided. So that's it. Any questions, comments, ideas?